about opinions. I'm just minding my business. If I'm grinding, I'm shining. Don't got time for the gimmicks.
Squat.
I'm it.
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 Squat.
Everybody got come, mama cries, dead sons, Lord please bless them. Back to the party, I'm just pouring my don't get face step before, so I live it up. When a come, better get them off. That's a floss track, better get them off. I'm a Kiwi and it's a dinner rod, so I'll let you finish up. I can promise I'm being honest. This super, being modest. I am your highness. I am the finest. You rappers, plus you a liar. Don't idolize and I don't admire. Been doing me for like ever. I'm a better me, more clever. It's a new way. We surfing, baby, new way. That's a certain, baby. Let's take a ride. Put your for the ones that die.
Everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. The time for talk is over as we are just mere moments away from the Super Bowl. Two teams now have a chance to prove they are the best. It's the Patriots going up against the Seahawks.
Larry, it has been a tumultuous yet utterly riveting 2018 NFL season, and it all comes to a close here tonight as we welcome you to Super Bowl 53 from two-year-old Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here on first down, got his man complete over the middle. It's Paul, and he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly,
and that's what you count on. And I like what you just said, first quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down, Seahawks, Wilson to Baldwin. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He sets a battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Because those defenders, they're rallying to the football pretty quickly.
To throw is Brady. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. Malik McDowell with a big-time sack on third down. And it'll be a loss of 7. On fourth down on now is the lefty Ryan Allen to punt. Fielded at about the 28. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
Give him 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. 4 yards remaining now on second down. From the shotgun, Wilson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Now Wilson on first down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner, okay? All right, on this one. But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing his way.
The benefits could be great. You throw it to a great receiver, he could come down with it anyway.
Now Wilson, he's going to wind up and air it out. It's caught at the 10. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. They give him a gain of 37.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays.
And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. With a first touchdown of Super Bowl 53. And the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Remember what
he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Brady now on first down. And Cooks hands it over the middle. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12.
I don't care who you put on him. He's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just 1 yard. On third down. That's White, and he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. On 1st and 10, here's Brady. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down. So now we have Edelman slow to get back to his feet. Appears to be shaken up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. They'll run it now out of the gun. And now running right through it. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Calling a loss of 2 on the play. And they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
As my dad used to tell me all the time, when you're getting ready to play a big-time game, especially when you have one going into a dome setting, better strap it up tight because that crowd can really affect things.
Especially on third downs like the one we just saw there with the incompletion. Oh, he's going to go ahead and field it from the 3-yard line. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
And oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. And out now come the Seahawks. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Throw on first down with Wilson. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
On third down, Wilson. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
That one goes for 24 yards.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They haven't shown the propensity to be able to stop him.
Fresh set of downs here. Again, Wilson. His throw caught at about the 5. And snapped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Goal line offense, something they've really been emphasizing in practice lately. Now they have a chance here to put all that hard work to use. Throwing again here, Wilson. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Oh, Charles, after that interception in the Super Bowl from the 1-yard line, I thought Pete Carroll would run it inside the 5 every time.
Sometimes I wonder if maybe Pete did want to run it inside the 5. But Russell Wilson, you know he's such a competitor that he doesn't want that interception to stand, that maybe he wanted to be in that spot to hold it a second. I can throw a touchdown pass. Instead, he's victimized again.
Here's White. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. They fake the handoff. Now Brady. It goes as a loss of six. And now third down. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Brady. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, we quit counting yardage on that one, didn't we? That was truly third and a mile, wasn't it?
It was. I thought they might just go underneath, but they didn't. They wanted to get the first down there.
Yeah, they tried to pick up the huge chunk unsuccessfully. I'm with you. I would have tried to take some yardage just to gain some field position.
It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Right. Can he put it aside? Let's find out. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Over the middle, complete. That's Paul. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A nice pickup on first down, 7 yards. Second down, Wilson. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next year?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
Now a play fake here on first down. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing run. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. He got 29 yards that time.
Well, there it is, partner. Brady to Gronk, their first connection of the game.
You think those two often in sync?
I don't think there's any question about it. And look, we know Gronk has a whole lot of fun, but he's deadly serious about his football, as is Tom Brady. Two great competitors, two fantastic players. But he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Brady now on third and goal. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line.
Third and goal, they decided to throw for it, but how about the play defensively? Couldn't find anyone open, left him nowhere to go with the football, had to absorb the sack.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And with 3 interceptions thrown already, we'll see. Do they rely more on the ground game here?
They may have to change things offensively to try and settle things down, not just for the guy throwing the ball, but for the rest of the offensive unit, because their confidence has to be shaken a little bit
And you just wonder, is the backup going to start to warm up a little bit over on the sideline?
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. A man over the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A very solid gain of 27. On first down, Wilson. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. From the gun, it's Wilson. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
A good chance this is four down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now, looking at a third and three. To throw is Wilson. He finds his man, Baldwin. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his sticks. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Remain here in the first half. We'll come back on Super Bowl Sunday after this. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Baldwin with it over the middle. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right?
Yeah.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done. So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have gets chipped away a little bit, maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right, those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. Again, he'll drop to throw. And oh, the gamble fails. It's incomplete. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. Well, I see what they were trying to do there. You pop up your holder, roll them out. You got the option to run or pass. Just didn't work.
Not at all. And the communication was excellent defensively to make sure that receivers were covered as they escaped from the line of scrimmage, because that's supposed to be a surprise to everyone, and that's how they get free. People forget their assignments on defense. That didn't happen. And think about the guy rolling out with the football, looking for an open person. No one there.
Helpless feeling.
Helpless.
And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Brandon Cooks, 63 yards. And the Patriots are able to strike quickly for six. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And he'll bang that one through. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. On first and 10, Wilson. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Wilson. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Akeem Ayers. Coming in from that outside linebacker spot, he gets him down for a loss of five. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. Here's Wilson to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The secondary has been roasted in this first half, but they get a measure of revenge there. Nice play on the deep ball.
Yeah, they're going to need a few more plays like that in order to get their confidence fully back, but that's one step in the proper direction.
On is the punter, Ryan, to send this one away. That's taken on the 25. A good kick, 48 yards, four on the return. And the Patriots take over. They begin the drive on the ground. It's White. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Brady now on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a second down. Brady to throw on second down. Wide open receiver complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. A big play there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And he's got it up and through. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we've come upon halftime here in Super Bowl 53 as we'll send you down to Orlando where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. They'll start the drive with a give to White. He gets away from one. And he is going to feel that one. Knocked down hard right near the 39. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16. They stay on the ground with White. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. Throwing on first down is Brady. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall. Third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Brady looking outside and he's got a man. It's Powell, and the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of five on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down.
whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either...
And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. He'll grab 3 yards on the play, taking it himself for the first down.
You know, I always talk about when teams line up for long field goals that you should be in a safe defense.
Right.
But you're also in a position here where this is a makeable kick. So rushing it is also part of the strategy. Maybe they use their aggressiveness against them on that fake.
Yeah, with a low trajectory, they're coming in hot, trying to block it. And you're right, and obviously it worked out. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Frank Clark with a big-time sack on third down, and it'll be a loss of 7. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
So after the missed long field goal attempt, this offense set up nicely at the 44-yard line. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. They find some open field here. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Second and very short here, less than a yard. Now Wilson. Room here to run. And avoids the contact by sliding. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. On first down. And left side here, it's Graham. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Offense in a good spot here. 2nd and 2. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll take it down here, just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. So the offense has it 1st and 10. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on 1st down. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. And he's got it. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's 1st and goal. Shift together here from the D-line. Wilson will throw again toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Down this close to the goal line, 1st down. Surprised that wasn't a run?
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on 1st down in this situation because 2nd down, that gives me that option of running play action and maybe throwing it.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. To throw again is Wilson. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown.
We see this route all the time, but when it's well executed, it's a beauty.
And it feels like the fade takes forever to develop, like that ball is just hanging in the air.
And the reason why is that the receiver is trying his best to work the defender inside and give himself space to fade away from him and catch the football. And that's exactly what happened there.
And he knocks it through. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. Oh, good move. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again?
And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
With no running backs in the backfield to help pass protect, all the receivers in their patterns, it's going to be hot routes. If they sense a blitz or pressure on the quarterback, they've got to be prepared to break routes off early and get the football. In this case, never even had a chance. They popped the ball free in the backfield.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
And on 2nd and 10 now. Wilson to throw again. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. The 2nd touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. The drive starts with a run by White. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It'll be a Patriot first down on a pickup of 16.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back, oh, he gets lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guys trying to find him, trying to peek around people to see him, and he gets lost, but this guy gets lost in a good way for his offense, picking up big yardage.
Now Brady throwing on 2nd down. And Cooks has it over the middle. Brady connecting with Cooks for the Patriot 1st down. Great changeup there on the route and got that inside release, made it a successful pitch and catch.
Well, the first thing you want to do is have him thinking that you're going outside. Make a move in that direction. Then you really don't run the route against the whole body of the defender. You run against a half of him. And the inside half, and he took it right across his face, got inside, and won that route in a big way.
Brady now on 1st down. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
On second down, here's Brady. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. They'll run with White. Oh, and now he bowls him over. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. To throw on second down, Brady. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. It'll wind up being stopped for no gain, and it'll lead to a fourth down.
That goes in the category of a play that the defense is going to cherish and excites them. A completion, yes, you give up the pass, but no gain. I mean, that's exactly what you want on defense.
And sets up the fourth down. All right, so this one's now back within a field goal. And if anybody tells you they see how this one's going to end, I'd have to say they're probably lying, Charles.
And this game's had more twists and turns than a good mystery novel. And I have a feeling we've got a few more twists and turns in store for us before they shake hands here.
Yeah, and a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now it's Wilson. He's going to air one out. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times, tried to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. Second and 10 now, Wilson throwing the out route incomplete. It's Baldwin, and he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Well, throw on first down with Wilson. Look at the spin. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. A gain of 4 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. And they're going to go soft on the corners. On second down, here's Wilson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. From the gun on third down, Wilson. Oh, leaves him behind on the spin. Breaks the tackle, now an alley. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. From the shotgun, Wilson out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. They'll give him a yard on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
On second down, Wilson looking deep downfield. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Well, the obvious goal is to try and score a touchdown, but at the least, adding to a pretty big yardage total for his intended receiver there, huh?
Yeah, well, when you've got a guy over 150 yards, keep chucking it deep to him, I guess.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can get it to him short, and he can make plays that way. But I like what you just said. Throw it to him deep and get it in a big chunk.
But incomplete on that try. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. Past the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Patriot defense has a touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides. So I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
So it's my kind of game. You know that.
Right. Oh, no, he lost the football. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. Powerful running.
I know they didn't tack on the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for two, and they did.
Boy, yeah, and everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heels. They weren't ready to be out there.
Yeah, it's almost like a sudden change, right? Either it's a turnover, you take it away, they stuck it in the end zone, keep the momentum going. Give credit to the defensive guys for rallying and stopping that two-point attempt.
The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And following the pick six, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
They give them 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. On first down, Wilson toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Now Wilson. And an alley to run. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Time for a break. We're back to perhaps crown a champion after this. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A good pickup there, a 22. Back to throw. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Back to throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal.
Nice, well-coached, a team that understands what's going on. They still have time to work the middle of the field, as they just did there.
He'll look to throw. His throw incomplete. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's thrown it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions. And that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
They'll look to throw. And he's got the big tight end, Graham. Touchdown, Seattle. Jimmy Graham, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Seahawks have taken the lead here in the fourth. And a pause in the action because the booth, they see something that they want to take another peek at to find out if this was a touchdown or not. All right, now the Seahawks face a big two-point conversion attempt. Here's Wilson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here's Parkey now set to kick it away. This is taken at the three. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. He's back to throw. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. What did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. Brady to throw. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That's very well timed there, defensively, because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. Man open underneath. It's Gronkowski, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. To throw is Brady. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
And that one is incomplete, and now we're inside of 10 seconds. Just 9 remain. Time for this one final knee to put a bow on this title bout. Seahawks are the class of the NFL. Seattle wins the Super Bowl.
Trying to say I'm on the enemy. Got a cold when my dogs can't get in between. I can't give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen, amen. Spent about 60 on the time, I can't even lie. No way in, no way out, doubt, do or die. So I roll when I roll, must be, amen, amen. Amen.
I can't ride Benz, I don't do peace. I beast, I gotta eat. Saber tooth, tiger, diamond, tooth, teeth. Rockin' right now, won't you come peek? I was outside. The way to shake me, your mouth wide. You need to say grace for you to say thanks.
Amen, amen. What's left in my life, don't know what's in store. I've been dealing with these blessings that I can't ignore. Putting up the numbers, we ain't keeping score. Amen, amen. I been on the block by my side. Run it in our house for us, 12 o'clock. Yeah, the hood love me, but you gotta watch. Amen, amen.
I just three, I don't do sleep. Yeah, trying to see movie. Yeah, we gon' fall through, coming through deep.
Amen, amen.
Yeah, packed it from the south, moved it to the west. Iced the logo on the cross, threw it on my neck. Yeah, when I rep the set, gotta stay blessed. Yeah.
Amen, amen. People tryna say I'm only enemy. Got a code with my dogs, can't get in between. I can give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen.
Man, put it into me. Everybody tryna take the identity. Everybody around me turn to a friend of me. Sit back while I take on a remedy. I cannot let it get into me. It's playing a toll on me, meant to me.
I done came up, busting down the whole broke, a step back. Watch people swag, ain't even gotta ask. What are those, what is that? Please don't touch my rap. Please don't touch my rap. I'm racked up like rappers, I'm wrapped up on camera. Get out on camera, squeeze like asthma. It's rare wrath when I wear wrath, bare wrath when I wear wrath. Might invest into some rap shit, Lord. Still shit rap, and I'm dripping on rags. Rick gon' be the tag, do the digital dash. Yeah, I'm boasting, never brag. Please don't touch my rap. Or the Chris Van Nash, Alessandra Gucci glasses, the W Anderson collab. Yeah, pop it like yeah, drop it on the. I'ma buy another. Cause boys bring it back. Yeah, you know how to make it last. Plus, and keeping tabs. I'ma fly first class. Wave will hit him with the. Please don't touch my rap.
Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Don't step on my Ralph Simmons. Do you know how much I'm spending? My closet, it worth about a million. To the little out the runway. Neck, then the kitchen. Ralph Simmons. All kind of crazy colors. Living color. Left wrist, roll it, ice. Make some Margiela, my sweater.
Margiela.
Mama told me never settle. Ralph Simmons, don't lace them. Gotcha, wanna.
Huh? What? Don't wanna talk about the paper. I swear to God, these got these be haters. They be hating, I feel out of.